أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أيها المسلمون عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله، وأحذركم وأحذر نفسي من عصيان الخالق ومخالفة أمره. أما بعد، my respected Muslims, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would always give an advice to the companions sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will guide them throughout their life alayhi salatu wa salam. And the companions radiallahu anhum, they recorded all the advice that was given to them by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one of the great companions who was giving a beautiful advice is Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. وعن أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: أوصاني خليلي بسبع: حب المساكين، وأن أدنو منهم، وأمرني أن أنظر إلى من هو دوني، وأن لا أنظر من فوقي. وأمرني عليه الصلاة والسلام أن لا أسأل أحدا شيئا، وأمرني أن أقول الحق وإن كان مرا، وأمرني أن لا أخاف في الله لومة لائم، وأمرني أن أكثر من قول لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله، فإنها كنز من كنوز الجنة، وفي رواية فإنها كنز تحت العرش. رواه الإمام أحمد في مسنده، وهو حديث صحيح. If we could take also this beneficial advice from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and act it upon and implement it into our lives, wallahi, we could change our lives a lot, from bad to good. What a beautiful advice from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Abi Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And this advice is not only for Abi Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, but it's for all of us, for all the Muslims, for all the believing men and women. So let us listen and benefit inshallah. قال أبو ذر الغفاري رضي الله تعالى عنه: أوصاني خليلي. My friend advised me. So Abu Dharr رضي الله تعالى عنه was one of the close friends of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was so close to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he learned a lot from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was never an stingy person in the knowledge that he got from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he shared with us radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So he says, أوصاني خليلي بسبع. My friend Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised me seven things. That I have to do seven things. Number one, أوصاني بحب المساكين وأن والدلو منهم. He advised me that I love the masakin, the poor people, those who do not have anything in life. That's what he advised me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, وَدُلُوهُ مِنْهُمْ. He also advised me that I should be so close to the poor people, those who do not have anything in life. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever advice he gives to the people, he is the first person to implement that, alayhi salatu wa salam. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the time, he would sit down with the masakin, those who do not have anything. He will sit with them, chat with them, give them hope, eat with them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What happened is so amazing. One day, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as usual, was sitting with Bilal ibn Rawaha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Suhayb al-Rumi, and Yasir, and Khubayb ibn Arad. They were looking down, but the people were despising them because they did not have family, they did not have money, they did not have wealth, they did not have anything. They have only Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the people were looking down on them. And the Messenger sallallahu was giving them hope, was sitting with them all the time. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with those men who are giants in the sight of Allah, they are so giants in the sight of Allah because of their iman. Because they have solid iman. But worldly wise, they don't have money. They don't have any prestige and any status in the community. And the Messenger of Allah was sitting with them. And then Agra ibn Yabis and others, they were top men, came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they said, O Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, we cannot sit down with you because around you, you have such low profile people, such poor people. They are masakin, they don't have anything. So give us a time that we come to you because we are so special. We don't want Arabs to say that we sit down with masakin. So we are give us a special time. Then the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, okay, I will give you. And even he called Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, to write down the day and the time that they will come and sit down with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then on that time, Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he revealed the Quran, yutla ila yawm al-qiyamah. Quran that will be recited till the day of judgment. Wala Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. الله أكبر. الله سبحانه وتعالى be patient to محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, be patient with those even though they don't have money, they don't have any name in the community, still they are my servants. They believe in me. They are saw giants into my eyes. And be patient with them. Stay with them. Then the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them, if you want to sit with me while these people are around me, you are welcome. Otherwise, off you go. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he liked the masakin. Today, this time and age, we respect each other because of the wealth and the money that we have in the community, which is not good. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked one of the companions in front of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man on a horse passing in front of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was not a believer. That man had a beautiful horse and he looked at a top man, businessman, rich man. He had a special horse which was very beautiful, decorated, everything he had. Then the Messenger of Allah said to him, مَا تَقُولُ عَنْ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, what do you say about this man? That companion said, وَاللَّهِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ هَذَا حَرِيٌّ إِن تَكَلَّمَ أَنْ يُسْمَعْ وَإِنْ شَفَعَ أَنْ يُشْفَعَ لَهُ وَإِنْ ضَرَبَ أَنْ يُنْكَحَ. He said, O Messenger of Allah, this man deserves, if he talks, to be listened. What is he looking at? He is looking at how wealthy he is. And if he asks for a woman to be engaged to be given to him, and if he makes mediation, his mediation to be accepted. Then after a while, one of the low people in the eyes of the people, but a mashallah, a strong believer of Islam, came walking. And then the Messenger of Allah asked him the same question. He said, Wallahi hada harriyun in takallama Allah yusma. This guy deserves, if he talks, not to be given a chance. No one should listen to him. And if he asks for a woman, he doesn't deserve to be given a woman. And if he tries to mediate, his mediation should not be accepted. But how did the Messenger of Allah reply to that? He said, Wallahi hada khayrun min mil'i hada aw kama qala alayhi salatu wa salam. He said, Wallahi, this believer is much better in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the other guy. If that this man, simple man, but he's a believer, is better than the earth of that man. If that man is filled in the earth, this simple man is better than him because he is a believer. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in Islam, we judge the people according to their iman, according to their deen, according to their akhlaq and manners. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Amara me, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded me, Allah andura, an andura ila man huwa duni. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded me that I look at the people who are lower than me. وَأَلَّا أَنْظُرَ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ فَوْقِي. And I should not look at those who are above me. So when it comes to dunya, you always look at those who have less than you. Today, if you don't have anything, compare yourself to Muslims, like our brothers and sisters in Palestine. Wallahi, one of them, he said, I didn't eat for weeks and months. He said my food was tasbih. Subhanallah. And then when we complain about lack of food and lack of money, subhanallah. So the Messenger of Allah told Abi Dharr al-Ghifari, always look when it comes to worldly matters, those who have less than you. And when it comes to the ibadah and the iman, look at those who are above you. Look at those who recite the Quran more than you. Look at those who finish the Quran one is a week. Look at them. Look at them. Look at those who wake up for night prayer. Those who fast Mondays and Thursdays. Look at them. Because they are your role model. They are above you. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أبو ذر رضي الله عنه سر أمرني أن أقول الحق وإن كان مرا. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded me to say the حق, the truth, even though it may be bitter. Subhanallah. However it's bitter, say the truth. Say the حق. And don't be afraid. One Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala was in prison and he was kept in prison. What did he say? He said, "Mada yasnau a'da'i bi ana jannati fi sadri ayna ma ruhtu fa hiya ma'i." He said, "What can my enemy do to me? I have my Jannah inside my chest. Wherever I go, it's with me. نفي سياحة وقتلي شهادة." He said, if they exile me, that will be like tourism. I will see the massive land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if they chop my head off, I will be martyred. Subhanallah. What a beautiful iman. He had such a iman, رحمه الله تعالى. So the Messenger of Allah told Abi Dharr to say the truth, even though it's bitter, and people are avoiding to say it. Just say the truth, and nothing will happen to you except which has been ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أستغفر الله أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين. صلى الله على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. موفي ورزاق الله خير. Some of us are standing outside and there's empty, inshallah. Come inside. Jazakumullah khair. Give them room. Barakallahu fi. Jazakumullah khair. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَمَرَنِي أَنْ لَا أَخَافَ فِي لَوْمَةِ اللَّهِ. The Messenger, Allah commanded me that I should not fear anyone. I should say the truth. I should not fear anyone. The way you will die has already been written. So, why are you scared? Just say the truth. Say the Quran and the Hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will only die your time. When your time comes, you cannot save yourself. You have to say the truth. And the Messenger of Allah told the Sahaba, أعظم جهاد كلمة حق عند السلطان جائر. The Messenger of Allah said, the greatest jihad is saying the truth with a tyrant ruler. Tyrant ruler, who doesn't care? He will jump off your head. And the Sahaba, they used to say the truth. رضي الله تعالى عنه. Not only them, our great imams as well. Imam Ahmad Muhammad رحمه الله تعالى, every single day he was slashed 1500 times every single day because they were forcing him to say the Quran makhluq, the Quran is created. And he said, no, the Quran is not created. Kalamullah is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then now we always praise Imam Ahmad Muhammad rahimahullah ta'ala, but who knows? Those who put him in prison, nobody knows him today. رحمه الله تعالى ورضي الله عنه. So in سبحان الله. And then the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أبو ذر رضي الله عنه said, وأمرني أن لا أسأل أحدا شيئا. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded me that I do not ask anyone. Subhanallah. One of the companions of the Messenger of Allah, when he was taught this hadith, even one day he was riding on his horse and his whip fell on the ground. And then he landed from his horse, he picked up the whip. And one of them said to him, Yarhamukallah, why don't you ask me? I will give you your whip instead of you landing from the horse. He said, the Messenger of Allah told me not to ask anybody. Subhanallah. So you ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah has got samawat wal ard wa kullu shay. He has everything. Ask. Pray to Allah. And ask Allah. Oh Allah, give me whatever you want. Ask him. As the Messenger of Allah said to Ibn Abbas, وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. If you ask something, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ask makhluk. What a Mahmoud can do for him? Nothing. Everyone is struggling for himself. Ask Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, Allah will help me. Say, Oh Allah, have mercy on me. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أبوابه لا تغلق. His gates and doors are open. They are never closed. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, قال أبو ذر الغفاري رضي الله تعالى عنه وأمرني أن أكثر من قولي لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And then the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded me to say more and more لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Which means I have no power. No power at all with me. I don't have anything. ولا قوة إلا بالله. I don't have any means. I don't have any power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإنها كنز من كنوز الجنة. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. It's كنز من كنوز الجنة. It's a treasure or one of the treasures of the Jannah. It doesn't cost you any money. Just say it. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That means you are free from your power, from your means. You don't have anything. You submit yourself to Allah Azza wa Jal. Allahu Akbar. See now the difference between a believer and a kafir. See the difference. You will see a Muslim who is sick and on the bed for 30 years. He will just say, Alhamdulillah, Subhanallah, Allah has blessed me. But the disbeliever, if he has a flu for 1 week, why? Then he may commit suicide. Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abu Qatadah رضي الله تعالى عنه. He came to a man. Subhanallah, this one is so amazing. The man doesn't have any limbs at all. He doesn't have hands. And he doesn't have legs. No hands, no legs. Only the head and the belly. Nothing else. Then he said, I came to him. And he was saying, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. And his face is shining. I said to him, what blessing do you have? You are on it like a meat. No hands, no legs. He said, Wallahi, Allah is blessing me. Allah has blessed me as he has never blessed anyone. Subhanallah. He said, man, you don't have legs, no feet, no hands. He said, Allahu Akbar. He said, Allah أعطاني لسانا ذاكرا وقلبا شاكرا الله أكبر. He said, Allah has gave me a tongue that I can remember him, I can praise him, and a thankful heart. الله أكبر. Look at that. Wallahi, being grateful to Allah is a blessing. It's a blessing. We always be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that He gave us. And Allah said in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to count the blessings of Allah, you will never be able to count them. We can't. We only say Alhamdulillah. ألا صلوا وسلموا على من أمرتم بالصلاة والسلام عليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما ورضى الله عنه وعن الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة وعنا بفضل الوجود بإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في غزة يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في المسجد الأقصى المبارك يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم احفظنا بعينك التي لا تنام يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.